I've been traveling the world and have covered six continents since 2011. When I arrived at the Gold Coast after cycling Australia in August 20, I decided to make my dream real. So what was that dream? To go back home to South Korea through North Korea. Have you ever imagined if a solo female Asian could cycle the world? In 2011, I thought it was nearly impossible as I had never seen it before. During my first year in 2011, I made a goal. If I can travel six continents without going home, I must come through North Korea. Because it does not make sense how I can see the world, but not half of my country. I want to show the world and Koreans that we can be connected peacefully. I started cycling from the United States in 2011. North America, Latin America, Africa, Europe, the Middle East, Central Asia, Southeast Asia, Oceania. In August 2020, I was finally near the end of my trip after 6 months. It was time to fulfill my dream to go home through North Korea. So I wrote to the South Korean government. The next day, I got a copy and paste type of response. I contacted Korean media and politicians, but no one answered me back. I applied for a South Korean petition. If I could get 200,000 signatures, the government had to answer with an official video. This was also a good chance to spread my message through the media. I have over 80,000 followers on my social network, but I only got 400 signatures. I was too shocked to believe it. I felt frustrated. I started doubting myself. Why did I travel the last 8 years without going home? What was the meaning of my long journey? Did I waste one third of my life? My friends have started having career, their own family, car, house. But I have nothing, just like in my early 20s. I never doubted my travels. Even while cycling up long, boring, difficult hills, I always knew why I was on the road. I'm curious about everything, and I wanted to see different cultures, food, people, and history. And I wanted to learn and grow from what I experienced. Lastly, I wanted to go back home with all my experiences. But the last part of my journey failed, which suddenly gave me many doubts. I've realized I was suffering from depression since March 20, since COVID-19. My failure to go back home made it worse. I couldn't fly home because I never planned to. So I kept cycling around because I didn't know what else to do. But I couldn't feel anything on my body, unlike before. I was not sad, angry, happy, or excited. I couldn't understand what was going on around me. I just felt numb. I even lost hair for the first time. And after a few months, I knew what was wrong with me. I just lost the point of living. So what is the point of living? I've just learned this. The point of living is the power to hold a pen to write something in your own book. The story doesn't need to be famous or amazing. The most important thing is to keep writing something. But I suddenly became unsure about what to write in my book. One day, I remembered that I wanted to make an app to make the world better. And here, I got a new goal to write a story. I want to make an app about traveling in North Korea, which I couldn't do in real life. I at least want to fulfill my dream in the virtual world. So I returned to stay at the Gold Coast in January 2021 because I love learning surfing. It's quite hard learning programming by myself as I don't know any basic knowledge. I don't know when I can make my dream app since I'm learning slowly. When will I go back home with my dream app? I don't know. I'm just happy that I can feel again, that I have something to write in my book. Life is about continue to write. The story doesn't matter. Just keep writing whatever you want because it's your book, your life. It's not for someone else.